Alright, well, hello everybody. My name's Smeep.
And this Lil. Is,
if you didn't hear that, it's Lil. You might have guessed this is our first time doing a live record without any kind of script. So this is going to be really, really bad. But it doesn't matter. We'll just fucking make it up as we go along, innit?
Absolutely. What have we got in store for today then?
Okay, well, as you've probably already guessed by either the title of the video or using your ocular visual aids at the front of your face there, this is a video about Pokémon. And it's something that I wanted to do a long time ago, which is basically a start to finish run of every Pokemon in all the generations and capturing all of them on the Pokedex. Yeah, you should see his face right now.
Every Pokemon?
Yes.
Like, as in, like, from, like, Red, Blue, all the way up until, like, whatever it is now, X and Y. Maybe
yeah,
beyond.
Yeah, I think they're on Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire now.
Something like that.
I should know that, given that I work in a game store.
Well, yeah, you should.
Yeah, but, I should. You know. Nah, honestly, nobody gives a crap. So yeah, basically every single Pokemon, starting with, of course, the first generation. It's going to be a long road, a very long road.
It sounds like it. I mean, that's a mammoth task you put upon yourself there. To be quite honest,
so. It really is, and I'm not saying I'll actually make it there, but I'll give it a fucking crack.
Absolutely, Bob.
A couple of things to get out of the way first. I've already said this on the advertisement for the channel in the first place. There will be swearing, there'll be racism, there'll be all kinds of jokes. This is not a kid-friendly channel, so mums and dads, just because it's got Pokemon on, doesn't mean I give a shit about your cunt child that you had with the milkman.
Wow. Wow. Way to put that in there.
Yeah. Might as well get it out of the way,
either. Yeah, all right.
I agree. I believe. You do.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is, I suppose, the first real episode of From the Game Throne, though it's not the bulk idea of the show, but we'll go on about that. We've got lots and lots of time. As I've already mentioned, there's no script, so essentially I don't know what I'm doing here.
Fever!
Exactly. We'll just fucking start the snowball rolling and see how it goes. I know I put the video on the channel ages and ages ago, and I said I'd do a video a week and all the same stuff that every YouTuber promises, but life kind of gets in the way sometimes, and I'm a lazy cunt, so.
Just a quick note, you called yourself Smee. Couldn't just keep it as Ash like everybody else?
I know, blood, it's got to be Smeep. I also, I don't know if it's gone past already, I meant to call Gary, Larry, as in Larry the Dumpster. Old school Smeep channel fans will know that one.
Uh-huh.
But I spelled it wrong. Sad. I only put one R. So I know he's Larry.
Wow, he does pipe up a bit.
He does, man. He's on them beverages, hitting the shandies hard. And his granddad can't remember his own name. What a knob. Basically, normal scheduling will hopefully resume from this point onwards. I can't absolutely promise what every episode will be. Obviously, if I just do a complete chronicling of every single time I play Pokemon, that's kind of going to get boring real fast. But there is an end goal for each generation, but we'll come to that when I actually get there. So this is just the first hour of gameplay, which you've all seen a million times. As you can probably tell by the stutters and pauses, I've got like a list of things I need to get out of the way, and I'm reading them. Probably should have memorised them first.
Yeah, probably. Yeah, you've been a bit more professional. But yeah, like we said, free word.
Professionalism is not the name of the game here. Fuck it. I mean, we're drinking beer at the minute, so by the end of this, we're done. All
anyone's game. Exactly. That's what it's going to be. Probably not game freaks anymore. But yeah.
Wow. Well, take that. Game freaks, you bastards, with your addictive games and shit. Okay, so, the main idea of this, as we said, is for me, at least in this generation, to catch all 151 Pokemon. Now, there's some inherent problems there, and they'll get worse as the generations roll on. You can't actually get 151 Pokemon in this game.
That is very correct. So, how are you going to get around that?
Oh, there's obviously the ones that aren't in Pokemon Yellow that are in Red and Blue. I'll be trading for. Get someone else to play them in the meantime. Might rope you into playing one of them. I do own all of them, I believe. And there are... Basically, I'm not allowed to use any kind of hacks to get Pokemon. But what I can do is use in-game exploits. So it is possible to get Mew, the 151st Pokemon, in Pokemon Yellow, which is why I've chosen this one of the three.
Right, okay. So doing like that. Catch the Abra cheat and then do it that way.
Yeah, surely. Yeah. So obviously you're already aware of it.
Not really a cheat, but just a ask about face of where you're getting the 151st Pokemon.
Yeah, that's it. I mean, Psycho on YouTube has already done a full tutorial for catching Mew in Pokemon Yellow, and it's as close to a legit catch as you can get.
Yeah.
And without going into too much detail, I mean, I'll link his video in the description anyway, rather than me, but without going into too much detail, it's essentially a way to execute arbitrary code within the game.
Yeah.
So you fight certain people and their Pokemon have certain stats, and those stats get stored in the memory of the game, and then when you either exit the fight or travel to a different place, it runs that code.
Yeah.
And you essentially recode the game on the fly.
Yeah, it makes sense.
Yeah, yeah, honest. Makes
total sense, yeah.
And if Psycho figured it out on himself, I want to know how. I mean, what the fuck? That's some serious next level shit.
That's been knocking about since, like, the first Pokemons came out, man. It's cool.
I don't know, man. I remember that massive rumour where you had to, like, push the truck out of the way using the Machamp with strength. And then when the truck was actually there, I shit my dick off. I was like, no way, I'm going to get a Mew. And then nothing happened.
Nah, man. It's that aberrity. It's been, like, knocking around since day dick. I've known, like, all my schoolmates obviously used to get Mew and stuff like that, and they was like, oh yeah, you have to go to this place, catch this Abra, and then do this in a certain way, don't fight this guy but fight that guy, and it was all very, very confusing. I never did it because I just didn't have that much time on my hands, too busy going out touching girls and stuff.
Well, you know, that's sort of like a given for yourself.
Yeah,
just true. a little bit of girl touching, just a smidgen there, make you feel good. Well, I didn't know that, so I learned something new. I thought this was a relatively new thing. I knew that people managed to get it through, like, modding the game and things like that, but that's more for when you run it on emulators.
Yeah, no, like back in the old school days where I didn't even know what modding was for a game. Like, it was, my friends just came along to school one day and were like, yeah, check this out, I got a Mew. I was like, what? How'd you get that? They were like, yeah, do this, do that, do the other, and there it is. I was like, huh? Well, I want one now. screw it, there's girls.
Screw the whole damn thing. I want blackjack and hookers. Actually, forget the blackjack and the hookers. Screw the whole damn thing. Sorry if that's misquoted. I don't really care. We had a guy in... Well, my brother had a friend called Matt who was also fat. So, of course, we called him Fat Matt.
Obviously.
You know, being kids, we made him cry on the reg. And he had a Mew, but he got it because he went to a Pokemon event.
Okay.
If you went to the event, I think you had to get in a certain position or above. And yeah, you got Mew.
Dished out a free Mew, like.
Yeah, I can't remember the details of it. It was a long time ago. Though apparently my brother also went to an event with him and knocked him out in like the first round. And he claimed he was cheating and shit. I'm like, you got your ass kicked, man. End of story. If you're shit at Pokemon, fuck off.
Yeah. Hey.
And by the way, I'm shit at Pokemon. So I should probably leave.
I was gonna say, you best fuck off then. Right, so... With it just being me now, I'm pretty screwed because I don't know what he's done, what he played, or where he played it. So, what the setup is that he's playing it on, because it all looks very orange.
Ah, well, magically I turned back into the room and heard the question. The reason it's orange is it's been run on a SNES using a Super Game Boy adapter. I believe it's called a Super Game Boy adapter. A jet button on the front.
Nope.
Big one. Big jet button.
Sure. I know how to work a SNES. Yeah, Super Game Boy.
It is indeed called Super Game Boy. And you can choose, like, you go into like a little pause menu, which you would have seen me do at the start of the video, and you can choose like different hues, and this was just the most least eye-burning of them.
Video-friendly, should we say.
Yeah, exactly. And even then, there's probably better ones out there. I don't know. I just chose one, that didn't look like complete shit, but it still does.
Good.
Yeah. That's a good point that you brought up about the hardware. Basically, there's a few rules I've set out for the whole thing. All the captures have to be legit or using exploits, no hacks, no mods. Trades are allowed, so again, someone else can trade them to me. I have to own the Pokemon, so I can't get someone to trade it to me, get it in the Pokedex, and then trade it back. So I have to keep that Pokemon, so I have to find people willing to part with Pokemon on an old gen system. It all has to be done on legit hardware. Which posed a great load of fun setting that up to record. Just trying to get the picture to come through in the first place was a pain in the ass, and then...
I fully imagine it was.
Yeah, and obviously, as you can see, the resolution's a bit crap. I mean, at the minute while we're recording, we've got massive black borders all around the edge, but I'll fix that in post and just match the colour background or something.
Yeah, why not? Keep those Pikachus and Pokeballs going on.
Hey.
Why not?
copy and paste that shit, man. Yeah. Plagiarism. Take that, Nintendo.
Yours.
Yeah. Speaking of which, if any YouTubers out there are a bit more familiar with it, I know that Nintendo are assholes with their licensing and music. I'm not going to silence this video, so there will be Nintendo music in the background, but it'll be quiet. Most YouTubers I've seen seem to be getting away with that.
Yeah, it's something to do with just keeping it quiet enough so like an automatic reader can't detect it or something like
yeah,
that.
Like content match. Yeah. We'll see how it goes. But if anyone out there has experience with that and ways around it, let me know. I know that a few videos that I've seen, they've used like the same music but re-recorded by someone else, so a cover version of the song. But obviously then you don't get the sound effects of the game. Another reason the music's going to be really quiet is Biaquaz, if you get that reference, 10 out of 10. The way I've currently got it set up, I've only got two cables. Now, you can send, the kind of cables they are, you can send both audio and video through them. They do the same thing, just component cables. But I've only got two, which means I've only got one side of the audio coming in, and my screensaver just come on, so when I've stopped talking, I'll turn that off. So you'll probably just be getting either left or right audio, which is really weird when you're playing it. I tried to give you guys the best side of the audio. And when I can be asked to get another cable, you get both sides. But I suppose it's neither here nor there. All Pokemon must be owned, all run on actual hardware. I believe, go on, what were you going
to
say?
I was just going to say, with like regards to anybody with any tips, like if you just drop us a line on Twitter. I'm guessing it's at Smeep Productions.
At the Smeep at the moment.
At the Smeep.
Yeah. Not at the moment, yeah. At the Smeep. Done. I'll probably make a proper one for from the Game Throne at some point.
Okay,
I do, it'll be in the description below. I don't know why I'm pointing down. I'm not actually being filmed right now, but I'm pointing down. This is Crotchy McGee there.
Just in case.
Yeah, true.
You never
Somebody
know.
Might be watching.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, Bill Gates.
Yeah.
What's up?
Microsoft.
Fucking
wily ways.
wily ways indeed. So yes, I will be setting up a Twitter, a proper one, and I've covered the music. One of the biggest issues I've had so far, as you can probably see, is it looks like shit. At least I think it does.
Yeah, it's a bit stretched, let's put it that way.
Well, it's the hardest thing, obviously it's an old system. I know you can get mods done to these systems. And like you'll get people that mod them and put them out in like a, they'll change the video type so it comes out better. I think like S video or something is probably the best one. I can't remember. I did see a video on it a long time ago on the, you know, the infinite wealth of knowledge that YouTube is.
Yeah, well, you know, the original Game Boy was 106 by 144. So, yeah, it's going to be tough to emulate that on a PC screen, especially nowadays where like, you know, I mean, my PC screen is relatively small and it's 1000 something by 768 or something like
1440,
that. 1440. I'm not too sure to be quite honest, but it's a lot more than 160 by 144, let's put it that way.
Yeah.
So
it's always going to look horrible. So yeah, if anyone's got any tips on getting a slightly better capture quality on the video, I mean, I know it's Pokemon, you can see what's going on anyway. It doesn't really matter. But it would be nice for it to look a little bit less like shit. Other than that, I don't know what I've written the word fairy.
Is it because you are one?
Maybe. Right, poofy bastard. What's going on here? And generation differences, I guess. I was trying to basically say I'm definitely a Gen 1er.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Same. Same. Like, after Red and Blue, then Yellow. I kind of gave up on Pokemon. I think I got a bit too old for it. I started expanding into other games and different bits and bobs.
Dead or Alive Beach Volleyball.
What? Well, you know. So, went along with the whole PlayStation era and Tony Hawk's skateboarding and all that goodness.
Yeah, well, I did the same thing. And I got through, I mean, I played Pokemon Yellow, was the last one I really thoroughly played. I traded in a copy of House of the Dead, and like Lil here's heard this story 1,000 times. I traded in a copy of House of the Dead with the light gun in its box for £7 towards Pokemon Yellow, and that was the last day I ever traded in a game that I didn't already own two of. It was a big mistake. I mean, trade-ins. Best trade-in at local game shops that shall remain nameless. Cunts.
It's cool, bro. Everyone knows a trade-in's a fucking pile of wank.
Yeah, there's ways of making it good, but, you know, we're not allowed to use them as staff members. Not fair. So, yeah, I'm definitely a Gen 1-er. I've tried to do, I don't know if you've seen this, there's a challenge on the internet. You have 12 minutes. I mean, we could probably do it while this is recording, just for the lols. But you have 12 minutes to name all 151 Pokemon from the first generation.
Not even once.
I got to about 90, and I was, like, quite pleased.
I don't reckon I could get that high. Like, it's been so long since I properly thought about Pokemon. It's ridiculous. The last time I properly thought about Pokemon was a couple of years ago when we had that bit of a shindig and we played that Pokemon drinking game.
Oh, God, yeah.
Swatted up for that a little bit. Sat there, like, with a list going, shit, oh, yeah, there's that one. And fucking Clefable, who fucking knew about that one? What's going on there?
I always forget about the ones like executing executor.
Yeah.
Nobody ever uses them in a battle anyway.
All right.
Just a bunch of eggs. Oh, it's dead. Nurse Joy! Nurse Joy, I've stepped on my egg. Can I have a new egg, please?
Just put them on the bing bing boo boo machine.
Bing 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 bing. Right, I'm just gonna grab me another beer here. I used to sort of play it in school. I'd take my Game Boy to school, and then my mum would be like, "No, take your Game Boy to school." Okay, and like for some reason, the guys that make school blazers make the inside pockets massive, so you can fit all kinds of goods in there.
They make them perfect, not Pokemon size. Well,
Game Boy? Guess,
yeah, that's the word I'm looking for. Shut up. Yeah, perfect Game Boy size. I mean, I had the old school one. It was like the proper, the big,
like a brick.
The grey one, but it wasn't grey. It was yellow and black. Apparently, it's uber rare now or something, but I don't know where it is. I hope I've still got it. But yeah, I had that one. And with a little bit of rippage, I could fit it cleanly into my pocket.
It's kind of like anal.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah, a little bit like anal, but you know.
Oh, just chucking beer all over myself. Don't worry about that. We didn't see it.
Yeah, so a little bit of rippage. I could fit that in there, and then, like, you know, maybe a game or two, and then I had the battery pack on the back, so I wouldn't keep losing it inside my pocket or anything.
Oh, yeah, just like a little grapple.
Yeah, a little grapple. You could just like quickly whip it out. Ladies. Quickly whip it out in lunch and have a quick go, or in break time when you only got 15 minutes. That was a 15 minutes of gaming time, that was.
Yeah, solid hardcore gaming. Don't talk to me, I'm playing Pokemon.
Yeah, basically. God, nobody went and played football that summer. Like, fuck that noise, Pokemon to be had.
I remember you'd get like the what you'd call like the hard knocks, or the bigger boys that, you know, Kevin and Perry are worried about. The bigger boys came. And even they'd be playing Pokemon.
Yeah.
But they'd be doing it on the side, like around the corner, so no one saw them playing Pokemon. And I was like, excuse me, do you want to trade for an Abra?
Yeah, but well, it's when they came up to you and be like, yeah, I heard you got this. You want to trade? You're like, okay.
Please don't steal my Pokemon. Oh, God. Yes, you can take my Pokemons. I used to sell them in school. It'd just be like 10p for most Pokemon, and then like the rare ones, like Zapdos and Articuno and all that, it'd be 50p. But it's like, because you had to, I could do the cloney thing. I don't know if you remember. Had to clone Pokemon.
Not off the top of my head, no.
Yeah, obviously two Game Boys and a Link Cable. And I might be slightly misquoting this, but you'd have sort of person A and person B, and you would trade the person that wanted to get a Pokemon from you, so a Pokemon that you'd cloned, would have to catch like a shit, like a Pidgey. Irrelevant, there's a Pidgey on screen. That was totally on purpose. So they'd catch like a rubbish Pokemon. Then you'd do the trade, so their Pokemon would come to, if I get it correctly, their Pokemon would come to you. Your Pokemon would go to them, and as their Pokemon came to you, you would turn off the Game Boys. So that on yours, you never received the Pidgey, but on theirs, they'd received whichever Pokemon it was.
Oh, so you still have your original Pokemon because the transaction wouldn't have taken place yet?
Yeah, on your side, yeah.
Ah, okay.
I suppose it's like really primitive lag switching.
True.
God, lag switching, man. I remember playing Halo when people had cable boxes and they would turn the box on and off and they'd stay connected, but it would like just fuck up the game for everyone except them.
Yeah.
God, bastards. But yeah, you used to make a little bit of tuck money, you know? Get two Mars bars instead of one.
Yeah, man. Yeah, some of those chocolate donuts.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, man. What happened? Jamie Oliver is a cunt.
Ruined it for everybody.
Fucking
turkey twizzling. Fucking making them disappear, bastard.
Did all my twizzles, man.
Did all my twizzles. Well, if I didn't have heard a catchline.
Did all my twizzles. Oh, God. I knew this was going to be fun to do. I used to sell the old Pokemon and then. Well, rather than Mars bars, you'd have to buy chewing gum. Because then you would, like, yeah.
You would have gone.
Yeah.
If you had chewing gum.
So, like, if the hard knock of the year didn't have chewing gum, and you did, and you come asking for it, you give it him because you'd be scared, you'd give him a whole damn pack. I ain't gonna lie. Sorry. Buy chewing gum.
Bye, Brian. I used to make my money selling baked goods.
Baked goods.
Baked goods that I baked in school.
baked as in like food or baked as in like,
Well, a bit of column A, bit of column B.
Yeah, whoo, is how you describe weed. If you didn't know that, God, where have you been?
But, you know when they, like in year 7 and 8, when they force you to do food tech?
Yeah. We call it home economics.
Who calls it home economics?
That's what our school called. Who the fuck didn't teach you about not spending all your money on drugs and beer instead of bills? That's economics.
Hey.
Yeah.
Food tech, man. Food technology.
Yeah, food tech sounds a lot more manly. I wish I'd done food tech instead of home economics.
Food tech? But yeah, it was all about cooking and shit. And so, like, we made sausage rolls, and I chopped them bad boys up and sold them off for 20p a pop. Kids, if you're listening, that's the way to go.
Hey, well, I've said before, what I want to do is just, well, this is, someone's going to do this now, but it's okay. Get an ice cream van, just kit it out with an oven instead, basically. Roll up to universities at like 2 a.m. when everyone's high as a fucking kite and sell like sausage and bean wraps. Shit like that.
Oh, man, just, I want a sausage and bean wrap right now.
Yeah, see what I'm saying? The business, the economic, that's home economics. Fucking hell. Anything, just put any kind of junk food together, wrap it in pastry, and stoners, they'll be all about that business.
You're not even wrong.
Yeah? Hey, yeah, you obviously make a little bit of extra money peddling weed on the side. The police don't need to know about that. They get free ones. That's me, David Oaks parcel. Yeah, you fucking did. It's your dildo, mate. How you doing? Yeah, thanks, me. Fucking
custom Pokeball.
Yo, Professor Oak, I don't care what you're asking me to do, I'm not doing it. I think I'm fucking Larry or Larry, whichever one you call it. I'm going with Larry, because that's what it's supposed to be. Larry the Dumpster was spelt with a single R. Shut up, that'll do.
I don't believe you.
Leave it away. I mean, confidence. I believe myself.
I'm pretty certain in the credits of that video you put Larry with two R's as well.
I'm pretty sure I did.
Oh, well. Unless you fucked it up on that, which is understandable. You
know? If I did fuck it up on that, then I must have gone back and checked and done it wrong on this on purpose. It was just that long ago I recorded this, I don't remember. I doubt it.
I doubt it. I doubt it very much. Right. Nice sound wave.
Impressive. It gets smaller as it goes on. I like it. It's quite nice.
Well, yeah, that's how sound waves work, but you know.
I suppose so. I suppose, obviously, this is all off the cuff, but one of the things, I was watching a video on YouTube earlier, and I can't remember what game it was. Assassin's Creed. Assassin's Creed. The new one.
Syndicate?
Yes, thank you. Where it said, they're going back to the roots. And that saying, I don't know if you feel the same, that saying in gaming annoys me.
Yes and no. It depends what they mean by back to their roots. Do they mean they're going to go back to their roots with the gameplay? Because, I mean, in Assassin's Creed 1, it was a bit samey, a bit repetitive.
Yeah, very true. Three quests in a main, repeat.
Yeah. So, in that sort of sense, then yes, that is a bit annoying. And it would be not the point. There'd be no purpose in bringing out a new game if you're going to do that. But if they mean with sort of storytelling and all that kind of jazz, then yes, I do believe that's a good idea because that's where it sort of starts sloping off or whatever.
True. Yeah, I suppose that's very true.
Because they start running out of ideas and they start going, I don't know, maybe we can do this and put some aliens in or something. And,
it's always aliens.
And
Indiana Jones.
You know, yeah. And send them off to space and, like, you know, kill the whole world and then magically make it revive itself or something.
Yeah, well, Simpsons theory, eh? Everything's got to be back to status quo by the end of the episode.
Yeah. Yeah.
But you said something then about running out of ideas. I think back to their roots is just slang in the business for running out of ideas. Got any ideas, lads? No. Should we just do what we did the first time? Give that man a raise.
Ah, you know, if you got him a raise, you got him a raise. You can spend that extra $10 on a hooker or something.
Oh, the old man. Major Pokemon fans will know that this is one of the ways to instigate the missing no glitch.
Oh, yeah. Of course it
fly
is.
To... Pokemon fans are going to hate me if I get it wrong. Cinnabar Island, I want to say. After speaking to him, you fly over to Cinnabar Island. And then because there's not a proper trainer over in the right, it uses the incorrect data. When you fly across Cinnabar Island and surf up and down the coast. I keep saying Cinnabar Island, it better be Cinnabar Island. We've got our research team on it now. Then you can come across all sorts of things. I remember a good old friend of mine, he wasn't very happy with me when I smashed his team in with a level 139 Snorlax.
What, sorry?
A level 139 Snorlax.
Oh, I was on about the bit before, you smashed his what in?
Team, yes. Well, yeah. I'd have smashed his mom, but only because I saw her tits, because she was breastfeeding a child.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, I was like, ooh, it's one of my earliest experiences of boobs. Yeah. And they were the best part of her. She looked like Caroline Quinton. And well, I say looked like, it was Caroline Quinton.
It is Cinnabar Island.
Yes!
Correct.
10 out of 10 poker points to me, bitches. But going to this back to their roots thing, like, I sometimes feel that certain developers, Sega, do it to capture an audience that they've lost. So we're going back to the way we used to do things, and then it's never what it sounds like it's going to be.
Yeah.
Which is one of the reasons I quite like the Fallout series and same company, I guess, the Elder Scrolls series, because yeah, fair enough, they kind of alienate their original fan base. Like Fallout 1 and 2, same kind of game. Fallout 3, completely different from Fallout 1 and 2. And then Fallout 4 looks to be the logical evolution thereof. I'm not sure about the whole slow-mo VATS thing.
God. When that deathclaw is right up in your grill, and you're like, ah, VATS, well, that'll help. And then you got like that one shot, and you go, poof, and then the mysterious stranger turns up. I mean, mysterious boss.
Yeah.
Turns up, pops him, and you're just like, yes. But if he's got that slow-mo timer going, and he's just going to bat you in the face anyway, I mean, what's the point?
What is it? Bethesda?
God damn it. May as well just give up now.
And I'm sure some of you out there will be going, it's not Bethesda, it's Bethesda or some shit. I don't give a fuck.
Nah, it's Bethesda, shut.
It's my show. Fucking say it how I want. Bethesda. But yeah, what was the other series I just mentioned? And I know, again, the same company, but the Elder Scrolls series, the first two, what is it, Daggerfall and Arena, I want to say. And then on to Morrowind, completely different kind of game. Morrowind was quite clever in the sense of it was so broken that people who were clever could use all kinds of, like, you could stack potion on potion on potion on potion on potion on potion, and there was no limit. So you could get to the point where you could, like, single hand slap any boss out of the way if you knew what you were doing, which I appreciated. And it made you think about gaming. And then they went a bit more user friendly when it came to Oblivion. And then they made it a bit more epic when it came to Skyrim. So those companies have never said, we're going back to do it that way. And I kind of respect that. Where Sega, for example, with good old Sonic, I know the Sonic fan base, I'm one of them, hasn't really got the best internet presence, but that's because they ruined Sonic.
Well, yeah, they did ruin Sonic a very, very long time ago. So, and every Sonic game since has been so hyped up from all the Sonic fandom that there is.
Yep.
Going, oh man, it's going to be epic. And then when it comes out, it as always, never lives up to expectation, does it? It's one of those. It's just going to keep going, oh, yeah, it's going to be great, it's going to be great, it's going to be this, it's going to be that. And then all of a sudden, bam, you get what you're given, and you're like, shit, it's not what I thought it was going to be.
Yeah, definitely.
And Yeah, it just, well, that sort of doesn't help with gaming at all either. You know, that everyone, especially nowadays with social media and all this, that and the other, rumours can spread so far and wide and so fast.
Yeah.
It's never going to live up to what somebody makes up in their mind.
No, definitely. It's like, I don't know if you know his name, Peter Molyneux.
I've heard of this.
You would have, if you've ever been on the internet and looked at any kind of game ever. Peter Molyneux is basically super famous for Black and White, which is the game that sort of, at least in my opinion, between Populous and Black and White, got him into the starlight. And I think it's Disneyland that have Imagineers as a job profession, or somewhere like that. That's what he does. He basically says to his team that he gives him money. He goes, I want this game to do this, 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 and the list goes on. And it sounds wonderful. Comes up with all these fantastic ideas. But then he's only got so much resources, so he has to cut all the ideas out. Like, Fable is...
Yeah. And you something to do with gaming. Yeah, Disney, well done.
Yeah!
Man, your brain's on form today.
It's because I've had a beer and a half.
That is the one.
Double that. I'll be at that point where driving's loads easier. Loads easier.
Sorry to our friend Chris, who's just lost a license for drink driving.
Womp womp. Wow. There is no shame on this show, ladies and gentlemen.
I'll call you out. I'll call you out good.
Yeah, clean. But yeah, so going back to... I'm not going to go on and on about the Sonic thing because it's been done to death. But at the end of the last good Sonic game to me was Sonic Generations because it incorporated the old and the best of the new and put it together. Like when they released that Sonic and the Were-Pig or whatever the bloody hell it's called.
Oh, God. Yeah, the Were-Hog.
Sonic Unleashed?
Yeah, I think
I
so.
I want to say.
Yeah. Sonic Unleashed, yeah, yeah.
Where, you know, the speed levels were ace. That's what everyone wants to play when it comes to Sonic. But nobody wants to slow it down and start, you know, beating up enemies with a Were-Hog. Which genius at Sega did that?
The one that got fired.
Yeah, hopefully. Hopefully you're homeless now and your children are dead.
Wow.
Well, just
whoa,
one of them.
Whoa.
The youngest one.
Nah, you want it to be the oldest one, so the youngest one knows what's up when, like, you know.
Like, to better our future.
Your dad doesn't do good. You're next.
Damn. Unison beer swing. Nice.
I was going to say, should we, like, stagger that? So, like, you know, so someone's always talking, but...
We probably should.
We'll figure that out.
YOLO. Wait, oh, God, I just said YOLO on the air.
Oh, you absolute...
That was a real slap. Got me a little bit in the eye, but at least it wasn't here. I don't know what we said. You slapped the words out of my face, man.
Good.
You slapped the words right out of my mouth.
If you keep saying YOLO, then you're going to get a slap.
No, you said it too.
Nah, that doesn't count. I said it in a descriptive context, not an actual context.
You heard it here first, ladies and gentlemen. Actual context. It's one of the most important things in life.
It is.
Perspective and context.
Defo is.
Definitely.
Right, so how far are we into this? Half an hour?
Yeah,
that's pretty quick.
Quite fast, yeah.
I'm just like looking at the gameplay now going, all right, so where are we at sort of thing? I mean, can you remember?
Bollocks, no, but I can make shit up about it if you want.
You've been drunk and slept since then? Or
I've done a lot since then. At least two wanks.
Wow.
At least two.
Just two?
Well,
at least. Probably more like a million.
Well, it depends on how good the local electricity current is and how much I can zap out of it. But anyway, basically at this point, I'm just grinding through the first area of the game. As it's not a, what would you call it, a news lock run, which is where you have to name all your Pokemon with a nickname, and if they die, you either have to permanently box them or set them free if they've fainted.
Oh, so, okay, I see.
So...
Heard of that before.
Like hardcore mode
on mobile
Pokemon.
That's it, yeah.
And to be honest, I don't like the Pokemon community from what I've seen. What's his name? Fucking Jaywitz and every other person who's ever played Pokemon on the internet. they've really latched onto it, so I don't know why Nintendo haven't made it a part of the game.
Yeah, like do it as a hardcore mode.
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
I mean, I suppose the argument could be it's like, you know, Pokemon's for kids.
It is.
Correct. Yeah. That's their main demographic.
Yeah, but then
they make all their monies.
They've got such a massive adult audience because of the people that grew up with it, so they could.
They could add it in for that, yeah.
Yeah, it wouldn't cost them anything, would it?
No.
Yeah, fucking 5 extra minutes of development. When Pokemon dies, it's dead. Just make it so you can't revive it. That's it.
That's, yeah, very true. Yeah.
Simples.
Although, I'd be mega pissed if I had, like, a level 100 fucking Raichu or something, and then, like, got its ass kicked by the Elite Four. You're like, shit. Start that shit again.
Oh, imagine if you'd been to one of the events and got like an event only Pokemon and then that motherfucker died because you accidentally transferred it into your Nuzlocke save. Dickhead. Fuck him up, mate. It's dead. Here, Nintendo. Hang on a sec. Let me just speak to you for a minute.
yeah.
Oh, good old Simon Hill.
What a waste.
Don't worry. You'll become accustomed with that name because we're going to diss him loads.
Yeah. Defo.
Fucking bellend.
Epileptic bastard.
I can't remember if it's correct, but the patch of grass that we just left on there, I think that's where in Red and Blue you get Pikachu. And I also think... Go on, you might be able to correct me. I know it's like a little square of grass.
Pikachu. I've always found Pikachu in the first foresty bit that you get to... Viridian?
I want to say Viridian.
Viridian
well.
Forest? Oh, man, I'm going to have to pull up a map. Viridian City.
Well, that actually is quite intriguing. Because my brother, when I first bought Pokemon Red, I bought it for myself, and I was playing through the game, and my mom said I had to share with my brother, and I just said to him, you can play it as long as you don't save it, and he had to literally start the game. I had to share it every hour, so on the hour I had to switch, and he had to start the game again every single time. And he did it, which is quite nice. And I ended up buying him a copy of Pokemon Blue for an early birthday present, purely because I didn't want him playing Pokemon.
It was nice of you.
But he said exactly the same thing you said. He said he found Pikachu in the forest.
Yeah, every time.
And I searched and searched for hours and hours and hours. And then I was like, it's not there. There must have only been one, even though it was a different save. Something to do with it being like the only Pikachu in the series. I don't know. But... yeah, I found it in a patch of grass just before the forest. But either way, that cost me hours and hours of...
Oh, yeah, don't get me wrong. It's not an easy find. Like, Pikachu's like a... I think it's something ridiculous, like a 1 or 11% chance or something like that. It's got a 1 in it.
There's 1 in it somewhere.
And, like, it's a small percentage chance over everything else, like your Caterpies and your Metapods and... all that kind of stuff and your Weedles, so it takes some time to get a Pikachu. Like you got
some doing like
yeah, you got to put the hours in. Like you know, it's not just one of them you stumble across dick first, going oh hello.
Oh man, was it? Is it rule 37 on the internet? The one that says if it exists, there's a pawn for it.
Something
and
like that. Yeah,
you're just saying stumbling across a Pikachu dick first has just brought all kinds of horrible images into my head. I don't even think I want to Google that one.
Viridian Pallet Town, Route 1. Viridian City, Route 2 is Viridian Forest, yeah.
Yep.
Yes! Got it right.
Check them on, that's right. But yeah, I spent many, many hours there absolutely just searching for it, and it just wasn't in the forest. It was in the bit of grass before it, and I found enough of them there. And you talking about percentage chances, I think I've got to do something daft like to get this Mew. I think I've got to die in a particular fight. So I box all my Pokemon and get a weak Pokemon. And what you have to do, there's a trainer on one of the routes. I'm not sure which one. When it comes to that video, I'll make a special out of it. But there's a trainer over one of the routes, and there's like, you know how everything's like on a grid? There's like two paths going from top to bottom of the screen. And you have to step into a fight on the square that the trainer would battle you.
Right, okay.
Well, that sounds hard enough, yeah? So you have to sort of walk around and like step in front of the trainer and hope you get a random fight from the grass. At the same time, the trainer should battle you. That's part one. But part two is you have to die in that fight. But like the most common enemies there are Metapods.
Yeah.
Which can't kill you.
It's hard enough all day long.
So, exactly. But what we have to do there, if I recall, is the easiest way is to get poisoned before you go into the fight.
Yeah.
Using like, I think, was it Weedle or What's the other one?
Caterpie or Weedle.
I think both of them can do. Go on.
I think Weedle's the one that does the poison. I think Caterpie's just got String Shot and Tackle to begin with, whereas Weedle's got Poison Sting as well, or something like that.
Man, you're probably right, to be honest. That's some serious poking knowledge right there.
I know, yeah.
And if it's incorrect, well, Nintendo should change it.
Oh, here we are. Percentages in the Viridian Forest on red, blue, and yellow. You got everything moving on my screen as I'm trying to read it, which is rawr annoying.
Because we did the research earlier and we're totally not looking at the internet on a phone right now.
Yeah, man, totally. No. Right, so Pikachu, you got 5% chance of catching. And then everything else is like a 50% chance.
So
you're looking at a 1 in 10 chance of catching a Pikachu, which is not a bad effort, but still a lot of time.
Rare as dicks.
Yep.
Still, I got him in a totally different location and it was easier. So maybe there is another place. But this generation of Pokemon doesn't have the legendary Pokemon that move around, does it? They're all in set places. I think one's on Cinnabar Island.
You got Zapdos. I just remember Zapdos being in the electric substation thing. That's where you find all like the Voltorbs and the
electrodes
that, like, you know, you stumble across one and then all of a sudden it's self-destructing. You're like, ah, bollocks.
What a great move that
is. I know, yeah. Especially if you're trying to catch one as well and it's like, oh, they use self-destruct straight away. You're like, ah, oh, yeah. God damn it.
It's like trying to catch an Abra.
Yeah.
You just have to chuck a ball and hope it works.
Yeah.
And I would love to know if it really was true, but like for me, it was throw the Pokeball, hold him down and B.
Oh, defo.
Yeah.
Defo down and B.
Yeah.
Always. Or was it up and B? It was up or down. I buried to see which one worked more.
Sometimes I'd do a little Street Fighter, man. Do like a little, not the Hadouken, the Shuriken move. And then hold it in. And it just, I think whether or not it was psychosomatic, it was, you had to do it every time.
Oh, absolutely. I still do it now if I'm playing. I mean, as I say, I've played it for a while. But
let's face it, you're having trouble catching a Pokemon. You're throwing them Pokeballs, you're pressing down and B or whatever combination of buttons you believe works. And then you get to that point inevitably where you try, all right, I won't press anything. And does it ever capture?
Does it both?
Fucking no. That's right. So clearly, down and B is more effective. Statistically, that's proven. That's right, tap my pen on there. Fucking bastards.
Fucking bastards.
A lot of them. I was going to say something about this, but it's completely gone. Should name the pigeon Butts. Butts use Gust.
Bat. Oh no, Pidgey.
I still remember when I first completed my Pokédex before I knew that Mew was a thing. And I was doing my paper round back when I was just 13 years of age. Maybe a little older. I can't remember when it exactly came out. But the last one I had to catch was Tauros in the Safari Zone. And, you know, and the whole Abra thing, you know, throw a rock at Tauros, it's like, see ya! Motherfucker, supposed to weaken that bitch with a rock? And Pokemon teaches kids to throw rocks at animals. That's what it does. And try to capture them. Get fucking, is it supposed to be Chansey that works with Nurse Joy? You said, ha, can I feel your face? My face is printed in braille on the desk.
Pokemon came out 1999. That seems rather late.
Hey, I thought Pokemon was much older than that. Apparently, I'm getting a cold. Great time. If you guys go back through my YouTube videos, you'll notice that every time I start recording for YouTube, I've got a frigging cold.
Solve that cold with a swig of your...
A swig of vodka. Away. Yeah, well, yeah. Beers first.
Vodka, yeah, man. Out. Europe, October 5th, 1999.
And I'm too stupid.
According to Wikipedia, this is, by the way, don't take that with, hey, you know, take it with a bunch of apples. Maybe not a pinch of salt, but a bunch of apples.
All right, well, I'd rather eat a bunch of apples than a pinch of salt. I don't like salt.
You don't like salt?
Nah.
Dude, brings out the flavour.
It just makes it taste like salt. But I love vinegar, which essentially does the same thing, completely masks the flavour of what you're eating. Excuse me one second. There you go. Now I should be able to speak properly again. Where's it? Is this?
Yeah, that one's cool.
There we go. this is actually going rather well. At least the commenters will tell us that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Definitely. Those YouTube commenters are going to be like all upon it and going, "Yeah, man, you lads are ace." Probably not.
Nah.
It's cool.
Bunch of knobs. That's what we'll be called.
Well, what's new?
What is new indeed. I tell you what, here's a small test actually. There's a guy on YouTube, we know him as Wasteland, and I'm sorry if I've just completely spoiled his internet persona, but whatevs. So we're what, 45 minutes somewhere there into the video, and I'm just now going to plug his channel. 45 minutes in, just Mike plays. It's hilarious because he's such an idiot, but it's a good thing. So, sorry, Waste Man. However, this is a good test to see if he actually watches the video all the way through.
Well, this is it, absolutely. He's got to get at least 45 minutes in before he hears his name. The Wasteland.
Check out Just Mike Plays. For some reason, he spells Mike with a one. That's probably due to his gross dyslexia.
Quick question on that, though. Why did he keep it a secret from us for so long? That's what I want to know.
I'm not really sure. I mean, being that much of a waste, I'd probably try and keep it a secret as well.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. No, he's honestly a lovely guy, and you should definitely check out his channel, because trust me, it'll make you laugh.
Raccoons might come.
The story when were you there in Wet Springs when he told us about the Doritos? His story was literally, I was eating this Dorito once, and as I opened my mouth, a bee flew in. Oh, God. Oh, good old Wasteland himself. We love you.
Absolutely.
We'll have to go for a beer soon, dude. Stop fucking around, like, with your professional people job and stuff.
And your family and things.
Yeah. Family? Who's ever heard of one of them? God.
Not them Ethiopians.
True.
Oh, no, wait, there's loads of them. That's why they can't eat.
Yeah, they're one big family. And they got one chicken between them all. Wow.
Sorry. I went a bit racist.
Well, a little bit. If you think about it, though, right? Every film ever, it's always the underdog who's got no family and no friends that becomes the total champion. So Mike with his family is going nowhere.
Margarine hat.
Yeah. Heart of a champion, margarine hat. And might be nice and put a link in the description.
Yeah, maybe.
It's not too far ahead in like this playthrough that I'll have to try and do the new thing. And like when we do that, and you guys as well, I'll stream it on something. You can do streams on YouTube. I don't know.
Can. Correct. Damn. Mm-hmm. Well played.
Said the king.
He did. He did indeed.
I don't know whether that's easier to do than like Twitch, or whether you can do both. I don't know. And also, we're rocking a big old fat England connection, and we haven't got no fibre optics, because we live in a town centre, so clearly we don't need fibre optics.
We live in the fucking dark ages, that's where we live.
No, yeah. Jesus Christ.
We can do this with the fucking hamster on a wheel, like.
Hey, speaking of dark ages, I've got to turn this heater down a little.
Oh, I thought you was going to go for a shit.
No, if I was going to shit, man, I'd be professional, do it during the recording, carry on. Sorry if you couldn't hear any of that, but yeah, whatever. If you're watching this far, we're clearly doing something right.
He went for a poop.
Oh, that's a good point, man. Seeing as you're in this video, I'm going to have to do you a little face.
Okay. Yeah.
It does have like a hat, but the background's black there. It won't be black when you watch the video. It'll make no sense what we're talking about right now.
The little face in the corner with the brown beard, if you will. And the eyebrows. So basically, the eyebrows and the beard in the corner, that's going to be on a picture that you'll be able to see the whole picture. But at the moment... did you just wink at me?
Maybe.
At the moment, it's on a black background for us. So we're sort of looking at it going, huh.
It's just some eyebrows and a beard.
Yeah.
I made sure it was a little bit red in the to get the gingerness that comes through my beard as well. Yeah. Just pick something gross off my back.
Nice.
Interesting. But long way to go. Very, very long way to go with this.
Definitely. Well, you're still dicking about in the first area, aren't
you? All of the I say Rattata as well, but people on YouTube I've heard say Rattata. I'm like, no,
Rattata, and get that shit leveled up so you get some hype fang on the go. That's the one.
That is the one. And you're right there.
Fucking about when you had Diglett's like.
Oh, God, Diglett. I always imagine that he's got like a massive hench body underneath the ground, and then someone drew a picture of it on the internet and it was funny.
Yeah, but you know, you need to level that up, get that Hyper Fang on the go. It's the one against fucking Diglett's and shit.
Doesn't that, Hyper Fang, can that not cause flinch as well?
Probably in the later versions, but yeah. No, it's definitely not in this.
Yeah, good point, yeah. This was such a primitive. There were so many like flaws in this game, if you know how to use them. There is a video on YouTube somewhere, I'm not going to do it, where stuff just doesn't work. There are problems with the moves. They don't do what they're supposed to do. And there's that in every generation of Pokemon. In fact, there's one, I think, in the newest version of Pokemon, which is supposed to stop you. It's something daft, like it's supposed to stop you running from a fight or stop a certain move from working.
Okay, yeah.
And it does the opposite.
It makes it work all the time.
Unless you play multiplayer. In multiplayer it works, but I suppose they've patched that.
Yeah.
Especially with like Nintendo's now. You know, because they're slowly getting more and more connected to the internet, it's easier to patch games live.
Yeah.
Which is something that Nintendo should have caught up on a long time ago.
Well, you know, but that is Nintendo sticking to their ways as they so very do.
That's another thing that's going to cause a problem with trying to get all the Pokemon legitimately. An easier way to do it would have been to trade online with some of the Pokemon games that were online enabled.
Oh, okay, yeah.
A lot of those are turned off now.
Sad.
So it means physically meeting up with people.
Getting them street pass hits on the go.
Yeah, could complete that for, what is it, Street Pass RPG? I think pass, I completed it once. Pass. Street Pass, yeah.
I don't own a DS because, yeah, I'm cool.
I have a Vita as well. I don't really use it.
Yeah, well, I haven't got a Vita either.
Yeah.
I had a
PSP.
I had a PSP, yeah.
Don't you still have it? Isn't it here somewhere?
It is. I think it's underneath my bed.
Yeah. You crack that shit out, man. I mean, I was going to say on the air, jailbreak that shit and get loads of free games, but I wouldn't say that on the air, would I?
No, because you're an idiot or something.
Yeah, God. It's stupid like that.
God. Damn.
And that'll present another problem as well, because I want to do all of this if I get far enough. I'll give it a fucking crack, but you know, I'm going to have to go back to work at some point and work 40 hours a week.
Yeah.
Capturing DSs, you have to buy like a very specific piece of Nintendo endorsed hardware.
Really?
Yeah. Unless you can emulate it, obviously, and capture it that way.
Well, yeah. But who would do that?
God, no one. Not unless they're on the original game.
Obviously.
If you can see our faces right now, we're doing that shifty left and right eye thing.
Means it's totally you.
If I had animation skills, I'd do it on the little image in the corner. Shifty eyes. But yeah, it's like, I think Nintendo even manufacture it. I could be wrong, but I think they manufacture it. And you have to buy that to capture DS. I suppose that what gets me though is Nintendo were the biggest ones for that YouTube copyright bullshit.
Yeah.
And yet they sell their own capture device.
Yeah, I see where you're coming from there. They want you to capture their games and play their games online.
Because it breeds popularity.
Then they want to charge the shit out of you for it because you're infringing on their copyright laws.
Yeah, it's like, why? Just be nice like everyone else.
Because? Reasons.
Well, sorry, that's unfair. Every company did it. Like, YouTube automatically did it. That was a lot of the thing. It wasn't the companies that were suing people directly or challenging people. It was YouTube automatically detecting that music had a copyright and then sending that information back to those companies, and then those companies responded.
Yeah.
You know, I can understand YouTube. It's kind of like the whole torrents thing. Technically, hosting a file isn't illegal. Downloading it is.
Yes.
And then I think they had to change that law and blah, 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 Pirate Bay and all that got banned off the internet all this kind of thing. Proxy. Proxy Bay. Nice. Man, I can't believe how much we've actually done. It's quite impressive.
I know, I'm quite impressed at the moment. I mean, we're getting close to that time, aren't we?
Yeah. Where we're clearly coming up with filler material that time.
Well, hasn't all of this been filler material, to be quite honest?
Very true.
Yeah, I mean, you had a little 10-minute spat at the start with all your rules and regs, but we're kind of over that now, so.
Oh, R&R, man. Rules and regs, rest and relaxation, that are stumbled all over that word with this beer inside me.
A flub flub.
Flub a dub flub dub. Well, it's been a long time since I've done like pronunciation and really speaking to a microphone. And speaking of, I'd like to get proper lapel mics and that kind of thing. And if anyone can help out by loaning a bit of equipment for free, carry on. Won't say no. I was going to say, yeah, so we're coming up to like, what, the last 5 minutes, I think that is, yeah?
Looks like it, yeah.
Give the mouse a wiggle.
Big massive 55 written on the screen right there, but you know.
Oh, rather than looking at that tiny number there,
yeah,
we can look at this massive number here. Well, shit. Ah, right, dead quick. Something occurred to me. I was coming up with this idea and wanted to get this out of the way. In the UK, to go on the radio, you have to have some kind of license. I remember someone telling me this who was into radio, like you have to have I don't know what you'd call it, like to have your radio show, you have to have a license to do it, like a broadcaster's license.
Yeah.
What's the difference?
Because Biaguas, right, that's taking up an actual frequency of airspace, if you know what I mean. Like whereas this, you're putting it onto a different medium and they've already paid for their medium space on the internet. So, whereas pirate radio, as ace as it was back in the day, was people just piggybacking on waves that
were available,
but they shouldn't have been used because they should have been available for somebody else who was going to pay for them. Whereas you're posting this, or we're posting this, onto YouTube, which is a space that's already taken up by YouTube, who are then promoting it for us.
Well, you know what? I'm really glad you actually had an answer to that question. Worked out excellently. Fucking poker.
Feel free to correct me if I'm wrong, because that was literally just made up on the spot. I could be completely wrong in that, but that is my view on it.
It makes good sense. I've also noticed there's a little piece of audio at the end of the track from earlier.
Is that the one
I kept?
Yeah.
And I want to move it in case we run over. But I don't want to move it in case it buggers up everything we've just done. Doesn't matter, it's fine, we'll start wrapping it up anyway.
Yeah.
So yes, there will definitely be a lot more of this. Not necessarily Pokemon every time. This isn't going to be on any kind of schedule, simply because I can't make the commitment to commit to it. On the note of that, I mean, obviously, it's been Smeepin' Lil for this one. It might be me and someone else. It could be a whole group of us. I'm getting that gas out right at the end just to finish the video. And if you are one of my real life friends, you are more than welcome to come and be in the videos and chat shit with us. All you've got to do is manage to try and fill dead air, which isn't as hard as I thought it was.
No, apparently it's quite simple. As long as you've got something to say, then just say it, I suppose.
True that. Yeah. It's advice for life, though. It's got something to say. Fucking say it. And speaking of good old Chrissy Carlis, she thought, said, you got something nice to say, say it. And it, I suppose it's in the same vein there. So yeah, if you want to be in the videos, by all means, if I know you in real life, I don't want random internet requests right now. Just basically come around, I'll let you know when we're going to do the records. It would be great if I could do it once a week, but I can't make that absolute promise. Simple as that. And it won't always be Pokemon, it could be we'll be playing any kind of random internet game. I'd quite like to do, have you seen... If everyone keep talking and nobody dies.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I'd quite like to try that.
That as well.
The old MRS says she'd like to try it, and I was like, nope. And she's like, why? Because I'll shout at you. End of story. You get it wrong, you'll be in trouble. But
I'd quite like to try that too. I think that it looks quite good. I think it's getting a bit old now from all the videos I've seen. Like, everyone seems to know what's going on.
Yeah,
so.
Well, that's why I've stopped watching them. Because I want it to be a surprise when I play.
You just need that list of instructions, maybe, for it to change a little bit.
Yeah, well, I think they do that, don't they? They release new versions with new challenges on.
I certainly hope so.
Yeah, one of the videos that they commented, like, you have to make sure that the version number of your instruction manual matches the version number of your game.
So when they
release new modules and new challenges and that kind of thing. But that's, again, why I've stopped watching. I'd like to experience something new when I finally come to play it.
Yeah.
If anyone cares to donate me the game on Steam, y'all just send me a private message, we'll sort that shit right out, you know what I'm saying?
dear.
Well, that's pretty much all we've got time for. Those credits that we're watching right now won't be on there even though it was epic timing.
I was going to say, man, that was just perfect. You're going to have to kind of leave that on there now and then just... Well, you can just add my name in. It's cool. I don't mind.
Yeah, I mean, exactly. All I've got to do is modify them. But it was pretty good timing, and it'll be about that when I put the actual thing in. Yeah, if you want to get involved, let us know. This will be an ongoing Poké project, and it's been great. So, see you later, or whatever you want to say.
Yeah, no, it's been great chatting, and yeah, we'll see you later, I suppose, and have a good
one. Peace!